Hello and welcome back to Ook Studio. Today we're going to be taking a look at another piece of art, which is Transformers 2007 Deluxe Class Bonecrusher. First, taking a quick look at the packaging, here we have Bonecrusher and its alt mode, which is Minesweeping Vehicle. As you can see, this is the Takara version, so there's a sticker. And actually, the bubble has more plastic than the Hasbro's, like this. And Hasbro doesn't have this part. And I find the Takara version is a lot better for securing the original shape of the whole packaging. Turning around, here we can see some nice pictures of him. And personally, I love the picture of the robot mode since it just looks so charismatic and forceful. And I thought the bio was quite interesting because it's just saying that Bonecrusher hates everything including the Decepticons. So that's pretty much about it for the packaging, and now let's get to the real deal. So here we have Bonecrusher out of his packaging, and I think this alt mode is just fabulous. So first, I think the most iconic part of this mode would be this Minesweeper. So it's on a double hinge, so you can angle it however you want. So it's supposed to dig a mine and dig it out like that. So it's got very nice Decepticon logo, which is painted in some kind of bronze, but it has some pearl effect. And also the windows are also painted in some pearly sky blue. I think this would have been much better if it was just a plain sky blue. I don't think the pearl effects are fitting well all together in the alt mode. But that's just my opinion. And it's got a lot of wheels, which is 8 in total. And of course the second one is fake, so it doesn't really rotate. But the other wheels are really rolling very well, and they roll all together very well also. And the bottom, I think it's pretty neat, except that we can see his back of his head. And the rear section is also pretty well, so we can see the ladder, which is very screen accurate. And unfortunately, the tail lamps are not painted, so that's pretty much of a shame. And here we can see most of the part are the same as the other side, but the sticker makes a great difference. So I think it says Bonecrusher, but I'm not really sure. And there's a very menacing bulldog, which has some gigantic teeth. Yeah, I think that's cool. And the front section is also nice, but I still don't like the pearly sky blue. But in general, I think this alt mode is very nice again. And of course, for comparison, here we have Studio Series number 34, Voyager Class Bonecrusher and the original Bonecrusher. And surprisingly, the original figure looks a lot more plausible and realistic because it just looks a lot cleaner than the Studio Series, because you can see a lot of chunks of the robot parts actually hanging out at the bottom, whereas the original one has very clean surface. So that's pretty much it for the vehicle mode. Let's get to the robot mode. So now we have him in his robot mode, and I think the robot mode looks just as good as the alt mode. So to explain my general impression over him, first, I really like the design of him because I can certainly catch some alien-esque feelings from him, especially for the very elongated arms and the pointy legs and feet. And the general balance of the upper torso is very satisfying because of both the wheels and the claw section. And I love the fact that the windows and the wheels are still visible, unlike the characters from, you know, like Age of Extinction or The Last Knight. And you might remember the scene from the first movie where he is just like roller skating using the wheels at his feet. So I'd say the legs are very screen accurate. And to go over some details, I really like the Decepticon logo over here. It's just so striking. And the head sculpt is actually very screen accurate too. And a lot of red paints are used to give some highlights to him. And I think they really work very well. But I just wish the arms are a bit better engineered, since right now they just look kinda unorganized and so chubby. And he is also somewhat back heavy because of the claw sections. But he's got some gimmicks, and first, you can elongate arms, which is already pretty long, and you can make him to look something like this, and yeah, he's totally an alien. And the other gimmick is that you can make the claws move by manipulating this lever, so it goes something like this. And this is kind of fun function for kids to play with him. So yeah, I think this is really a nice robot mode. Articulation wise, first, the head is actually on the ball joint, so it's got some quite a good movement. And you can pull up and down the shoulders, and you can also rotate it. And there's another shoulder parts. And of course you can elongate the arm, and the wrist bend due to transformation, and no waist articulation, and ball jointed legs, rotation at his thigh, and 90 bend at his knee, and some I guess you can call it an ankle tilt hitch, although it doesn't really work well. And some movements for his feet, or I should say toe. So actually he's not really bad in terms of articulation, which was actually a lot better than I anticipated. So I brought the Theater Series Bonecrusher again in his robot mode, and I cannot deny the fact that the Theater Series is a lot better than the original one. But considering this was actually made in 2007 and it was never remolded as a new character or anything like that after the first movie, this really served well for the figure of Bonecrusher before the Studio Series came out. Bonecrusher was actually somewhat rare in 2007, so I was still really really happy when I finally got him, like even 10 years later, since he's such a great figure. I have to admit that the Studio Series Bonecrusher is better in terms of details and molds, but I think this original figure still has its own charms. Especially the Alt mode I think is even better than the Studio Series, and of course there's the awesome claw gimmick which we don't see nowadays. So I definitely recommend picking him up if you can find it at a reasonable price. Hope this video was helpful and fun, and if it was, don't forget to hit the like button and get subscribed, and let me know if there's any figure you wanna see a review by leaving some comments. And I'll see you at the next review. Thanks for watching.